What's going on, guys? I am Trigger, and no longer shall I be known in the 7 Days community as the guy that does this.
That way. Alright, yeah. Oh, I'm not doing. Trigger, have you tried not getting it? Thank you, Doc. Thank you. I've tried it. To be fair, it doesn't really work for me. What the fuck? Ah!
All this.
Yes. Ah! Fucking hell! Fuck me! Scared the fuck out of me!
All this.
Broken glass. So what can I do with this? Now use it. Just use it.
So, to get away from the stigma of the guy that eats glass, we are going to be playing 40-minute days, insane difficulty, 7-day hordes with a 7-day range, which I'm pretty sure means that it could just happen at any time. And I haven't got horde notifications on, so I don't know until just before that it's game time. And best of all, permadeath.
Look, if you had one shot, one opportunity.
Yeah, I know, bad joke. I'm only joking, I'm probably going to die in about 5 minutes. So let's get it. And we are in. Now, this beginning bit is boring, and I'm sure plenty of you have done this bit many times, so I'm not going to bore you with it. I'm just going to pound it out as quick as I can and get to the trader, and I will bring you back when I've done that. Okay, that's the last thing we had to do. So, oh my fuck. That's not good. Right, we're just going to have to get a trek on. Yeah. Right, so, okay. First day is going to be spent running. So we're going to head to the trader and hopefully find somewhere near the trader which we can make our starter base, somewhere that we can survive the night, basically. So, again, unless anything super exciting happens on my way to the trader, I'm going to just skip there and I'll see you then. Right, here we are, we made it to the trader. Nothing too eventful on the way here, avoided pretty much all confrontation. Just made a load of arrows, a load of wooden blocks, nothing too special really. Nice, pinkers. Okay. So, just gonna loot this place. If there is anything to loot. Ooh, that is lovely. We have zombies in here, though. Wrench as well. Cooking pot. Oh, the trader's giving me everything I need.
Hey, jackass, can I lighten that backpack up for you?
What you call me?
So, start a quest and get into the trader out of the way. I pretty much sell everything on me I could. Then the next step was just to find a POI relatively close. I could at least just get my head down for the night, all the while hoping I didn't do anything stupid like walk straight into a couple of vultures to get myself killed on day one. Oh, what a noob. Fucking vultures. Don't need them in my life. What's up there? Oh, hidden stash. Nice. What do we have here then? I mean, this could be all right. I need wood to build. Okay, let's turn this little shack to ass. Have to get rid of that. This might take a while, so once again, I'm gonna shoot off and I'll come back once I've got this walkable, at least. Whether or not building here is a good idea remains to be seen, but being completely honest, I have no idea what to expect from the coming hordes. So taking the pussy option of basically sitting at the top of a tree the fat bully can't climb seems a pretty good option to me. At this point, I didn't have anything in my head design-wise, so the first step was just taking the space I had at the top of the POI and making it livable. To do that, I had to knock out the metal beam and the wall panels on either side of the room and build a floor. This caused me some issues when it comes to storage box placement, but nothing that can't be sort of sorted out in the future. The goal of the next day was just to get some quests done and get my level up. Ooh, XP. And there we go. Fuck, that's ages. I had to literally take out the whole central metal bar, and then I had to take out the whole edge. So as you can see, like there, it's overlapping there. So I had to take out like these on like the bottom run. I don't know. Let me just test actually. Is that actually going to allow me to put a chest down? Not. So let's just head out and do that quest before we do anything else. I think that makes sense. Okay. Right. Let's get going. And then we fuck shot Oscar. Cause I ain't fighting you lot. It's how that. I think we got bacon and eggs recipe, I think. What did we get? Did we? Yeah. Nice. Get that back to the trader. It's only 11. We might be able to do another one. We're living the dream. The buried supplies ones are easy, aren't they, really? It is the closest, so I'll go with that again. What are you standing there for? Don't you? I'm gonna see if I can get this done today. Nice. Let's go, baby. I reckon I've got enough time. It's just running, isn't it? That'd be nice. That's two quests, an airdrop, in one day. I'm happy with that. What do we got? That's not bad. That is not bad. I will take that all fucking day long. I've got antibiotics. Get another job while I'm here. Fetch quest. 738 meters. Okay, have to be that. It's a deal. Right, like I said, that's been a really good day. Two quests, an airdrop. Got loads of food and stuff now. Just really need to get out looting. So the aim of tomorrow is to try and work my way through, hopefully, a couple of properties along there, and try and get some half decent loot. But I'm not going out at night, not at the moment. I'm not fighting sprinting zombies. Not sprinting, I pussied out on the sprinting, but you know what I mean. I've only got a level one everything, so there's just no point going out there. So I'm just going to chill in here for the night, and we'll come back in the morning before we head out. Right, let's get going. So yeah, ooh, pay attention. Let's try and clear some of these then. Down. Come on. Come on. Talk to me. What? What? All the way, son. All the way. That's what we like. Oh, no. Oh, no. That. Have another one. Have another one. And twat, and he's out. So, little butcher's hook. Nice. Bit of moolah. And then swing. Lucky I had stamina then. Oh. Right, the clearance is going well so far. Another one bites the dust. Oh, yes. Don't know where that's coming from. Do not want to get trapped in here. Oh, this has been super worth it. Oops. No. Fucking hell. Imagine if that didn't let me get out of that animation. Man. I mean, fucked. Oh, shit. You alright, son? Just go for center mass. Can't go wrong then, can you? For fuck's sake. Can't go wrong then, can ya? Sweet. Okay. Hit everything but her. Doing bad, but not doing bad. I don't want to get into myself. Didn't even need to fucking do that. Right, I need to get out of this, back to my gaff. She's there. Oh, happy day. There's the vultures. Fuck, it was vultures. Don't come for me now. Ah! No! Follow me there. No. I'm actually like shitting myself a little bit. I thought this was going to be like simple, get back to the gaff. No. No. Oh my god, please stay there. Or not. I'm like so encumbered. I'm so encumbered, I can't even get up to the house. Oh, I need to get that honey. Mate. it's like in, oh, it's underneath me. Fuck. How did it get in there? Bugged out. Gone. This stupid. Ah! Fucking now! My heart is pumping, you bastard! Okay, right. So there is day four beginning. We're okay for food. We're okay for pretty much everything. Need to get some stone so I can. We need to go to the trader. So I'm going to try and get some stone before I go to the trader. Door knocks me down. Come on, just fucking die. What do I need for a forge? Oh, I need that lever then. 50 stone. Okay. So I do actually need that lever. This is where I need to get this lucky loot on. Stick with the lucky looter going on at the minute. That should help me if I go and clear this building. Or this one, maybe. This is only one story. Come on, just drop it. Drop it here, son. Oh shit, oh shit. Fuck me. Sweet. Ooh. He did not like that. Nice. Go. Fuck me. Nice. I mean, right, let's just get rid of this shit. I'm trapped on a fucking curtain. Is that it? Bitterly disappointed. Yes. Got one. Got one of the little bastards. Yes. Spazzing out now. Jesus Christ. Pissed him right off, didn't I? So I just realised that up until this point I haven't actually shown sort of this screen. So yeah, no deaths, 27 kills, game stage 13, level 8. Not bad. This is where I wish I knew the game better. It's like, where do you spend your money? Let me get the pistol. Get as much 9mm ammo as I can. And that'll do for now. We've got a gun. Oh, I think that was money well spent. Let's get this quest done. Mate, the nerd pole might be the option here. Sneak attack on this guy. I was just gonna have to go in there. Nerd pole would come in handy. I'm not even going to muck about that. I'm happy with that. Nice. It's the titty wobble woman. Dunk. Dunk. Oh. Oh, I'm so glad I didn't buy that. Level 3 sledge. Don't mind if I do. How much is the value of that? Oh, that's nice, actually. Yeah. Happy days. It's nice when it's worth your time. We've got a shit ton of stone. We've got a load of wood. So hopefully we can build a forge now. And then I can build a better door. I need to sort this out. I didn't realise this was literally like paper above my head. This isn't good. I suppose... I'd have to see what I can do here. Will that work? It last one done. Bosh. So it has just turned morning of day 6, and I've literally just finished sorting the roof out. At the moment it's just wood, so I think today would be a good day to just maybe go out farming, try and get some of this to cobblestone, or at least the strongest form of wood ready for the horde, which is either going to be tomorrow night or very soon after. So yeah, I think it might just be a good consolidation day today. But I mean, aesthetically it looks pretty decent compared to what I walked into, but whether or not it will hold up against the horde, I don't know. But I suppose it's more actually the bottom that needs to hold up to the horde. This isn't really the horde base, this is just I don't know if I thought this through very well. Loves it. Not only generation, you never feel the weight, but never encumbered at night. Oh my god. Wow. That's amazing. Give me that. Nurse. Shouldn't have taken that hit off that guy though, that's stupid. But I don't know how to repair this. Okay, and we're back, start of day 7, which I can only assume is Horde Night. Like I said, we're not going to be getting any notifications in-game as to whether or not it is Horde Night, so we've just got to wait and see. But we've gone 6 days now without one, so I can only assume it is going to be. I've just made an iron door. I've been smelting iron all night. Get that on there. I don't know if locking it is a thing, sort of, or whether that's just a PvP thing, but we won't take the risk. And yeah, so we got some good stuff on the go, so I can turn it off, that's actually done. We've got loads of water being made overnight as well, so we'll take that, leave that in there. Just gonna have some grub. And then we're going to head out. I don't know whether the best thing, because we're going to have to fight this horde. And they can't get to my base. So they're just going to smash the shit out of down here. So I don't know whether I just fight the horde on my platforms here. Is that the best way to do it, maybe? I honestly don't know. Not a seasoned vet at this. Just get this supply drop. Oh, okay. That was. Jesus. That's nice. Take that all day. Just stack me up. It's got first aid kits for days there. That's not bad. I am getting all this cobblestone. Don't even care. Oh. That works for me. Adios, amigos.
Well, looky here, boys. We got ourselves a real-life hero, and now he wants to be paid.
Perfect timing for the Molotovs, just before Horde night. Range damage 40. Range damage 39. It's 380 quid. I can nearly fucking buy that. I just need to go in and come back. No way, don't tell me that's a wandering horde just before horde. Let them wander on. Oh no. Everything that I wanted to do. I don't even know if this is going to work. I don't quite know how to take on the horde. I think I need to maybe stay in here to see if any vultures come, maybe. I'm starting to cack myself now. 7 days of like grinding through, it could all come crashing down right now. Yeah, let's just wait and see if any vultures come here that I can kill, and then I can just go down there and kill the rest of them, hopefully. I'm just hoping it's not a ridiculous size horde. 51 kills, 25 game stage. Oh shit. Oh man, I did not think. I did not think they'd be getting up here. You got that easy. Thank you. Okay. I don't know what to do now. I'll just get down there and run and gun it. Whoa. Use one of these. Oh shit. Did it. Oh. At least I think we did it. Oh, shit, man. That was intense. I was not prepared for that at all. I quite like the bass. It needs work, definitely. need to check that out, definitely. But I like it. It sort of fared all right. They just it funneled them, but then they do come to this area. Let's have a look at the damage. So we've battered through a load of these. Not too bad. Just like battered through a load of wood, really. There's still so much. This is such a good building. There's so much to its core to keep it stable, and it doesn't cost a lot to like reinforce it, really. So there we go, our first week on insane difficulty. Yeah, it's really testing. 40-minute days, you can't really get too much done in a day. But we're getting there. We're progressing more than I thought we would. I thought we'd be dead by now. But you just got to really take your time on this difficulty and take it step by step. Don't overdo it. Don't rush into places. And as we found out with the wolves, sort of keep your eyes open. And the vultures especially, sort of, yeah, if they come after you, it's a bit of a nightmare. But we got to the end of it. We've seen what the base can do during the horde. It definitely needs a lot of work. So I think this week is probably best spent mainly getting this base ready for the next horde. So I'm probably going to do that and do some missions in between, because I do need to obviously still upgrade my gear. But the base definitely needs a lot of work if it's going to survive another horde like that. Anyway, I've been Trigger. We'll see you next time. Let's get it. Woo!